All of the people involved with NASA's Cassini spacecraft are preparing for Cassini's final plunge into the planet Saturn on September 15th. One small portion of the people who have spent years working on Cassini includes the team behind the SIRS instrument, the Composite Infrared Spectrometer. SIRS was built right here at the Goddard Space Flight Center and has been massively successful in operating without a single command error in 13 years and delivering groundbreaking thermal and compositional data of Saturn and its moons. Personally, I think that the people behind the scenes in the trenches operating the instrument are just as interesting as the scientific discoveries they've enabled. The SIRS team includes software engineers, project scientists, people who calibrate the data, people who write commands for the instrument, and more. Some have been on the team for just a couple years, while some have been working with SIRS for over two decades.
How would you describe the SIRS team and your group of people?
In what terms?
glowing terms.
We're more like a family than a group of colleagues at this point. We've had, no one's left the team in a decade, so.
Oh yes, every time I go into a meeting, no matter my mood, these people always make me laugh because they're always, it's always funny, yes.
I found that too, because before you walk in the door, you hear all this laughter coming from the room, like before the meeting starts, during the meeting, and as on our way out the door, so.
Yeah, it's critical to be able to get along because it takes so much to get these commands up to the instrument. There's a lot of planning that goes on in the background, months in advance before they're ever set up.
We have, there are members who are very close outside of the office. We've had sort of a relationship start as friendship, bloom into something.
Well, for example, we met when I came here, and we were just friends for many, many years, right?
That's the story we're told.
But then one day she posted on Facebook picture of us getting married.
We're all very happy for you.
Thank you. And now we have a boy.
Cassini, 2 years old.
A Cassini baby,
yes.
Super small.
We have a lot of Cassini babies, though. Yeah. All your kids, my kids. Terry's got a bunch, yeah. Carrie's got a bunch. Carly's got a bunch. You don't have any.
I was born before Cassini, though.
That's true. At least there's that.
What was one really dramatic or exciting or memorable moment from your time with operating the SIRS instrument?
The most exciting times are the ones at 2 a.m. that I fortunately haven't had to be up at 2 a.m. myself, but some of these people have, where some emergency occurs on the spacecraft and it has to be solved immediately.
My son Wesley was born in November 2010. Just 2 hours after he was born, there was an anomaly in the spacecraft. And it basically took about 15 days to recover from that anomaly. So every time people ask me, what happened on this day? I know exactly what happened because that's when my son was born. I call it the Wesley anomaly.
But there's a much larger picture. We're operating the instrument and we've been doing that for 20 years. But before that, the instrument had to be built by, and it was built by an army of people here at Goddard who were all very dedicated, just like we are. And those people all had a very good time building the instrument.
We have a little mirror that scans back and forth inside the instrument. This little mirror moving 1 centimeter over since 2004, we've calculated it by the end of mission, it will have run 4 marathons. And it has not failed. And the engineers here at Goddard said it had an infinite lifetime. And I kind of laughed because, you know, what moving part has an infinite lifetime? Well, I guess we'll never prove it because after 20 years, it's still working fine. But that just really amazes me, the quality of Goddard engineering.
What are you most proud of with the SIRS instrument and how the team has operated over the years?
The best team. No, it's true, right? We have the most publication, the most data acquired, we have the highest quality of archived data, we have flawless operation.
Cutest children.
Cutest children.
What will that final moment be like when Cassini stops sending back data?
We'll be waiting for that final signal, but Cassini will have already burned up an hour and a half later.
That's right.
Earlier, because it takes that long for light to get here from Saturn.
Yeah.
It takes that long for the signal that was the final signal to get back to Earth. So Saturn will already have swallowed up Cassini by a long time before we actually see that last signal.
Yeah.
I think we'll know that when we're sitting there.
We will. It's sad.
I think it's a little hard to anticipate people's reactions. I mean, it's like a death in the family at a certain level. And you know it's coming and so on, but just how you react at a gut level, some people will be surprised.
For you, what will that moment be like when Cassini ends?
Sad.
Yeah.
I worked on the Galileo mission just tangentially as a grad student, and this mission discovered just as much as Galileo did around around Jupiter, and at the end you're left with more questions than you are answers.
I'm thinking,
so there's life after Cassini.
Yeah, I'm thinking even after the mission ends, though, this group will be providing data to the research community for many years to come. So I'm sure folks will go back and analyze and reanalyze and the data over and over again, and new discoveries will probably continue to be found for a long time.
Are there any other thoughts about Cassini and this year's instrument that you want to share on camera before we wrap up here?
This is the group you can depend on. We all can depend on each other, no matter what, no matter how much time passed. 3 months you could walk into someone's office and they're there for you. And that's what I'll remember, you know?